During the last week, a string of more than half a dozen articles were published with titles stating that the Canary Islands government had activated their volcano emergency plan involving the same region which produced a destructive eruption 3 years ago, the island of La Palma. Some of these same articles even added the phrase, "Don't panic," which despite author intention due to how some will react could very well have the exact opposite effect. And, following just that, I was sent a message by one of my viewers who claimed that Cumbre Vieja was showing new unrest. It appears that some people even interpreted these aforementioned articles to mean that another volcanic eruption would soon follow at the Cumbre Vieja volcano. All of this was in response to a report of, air quotes, increased volcanic gas emissions. And yet, the underlying report which led to all of these articles that in my opinion have sensationalist headlines and appear to have misled some readers was being greatly taken out of context. It is true that yes, at the present, the Cumbre Vieja volcano is at an alert level of yellow per Involcan, the volcano monitoring agency in the Canary Islands. However, this is quite misleading as the Cumbre Vieja volcano has stayed at an alert level of yellow since February 4th of 2022. This alert level has been maintained not due to increasing volcanic activity, but rather due to the fact that Cumbre Vieja's shallow and deep magmas and existing lava flows in place during its 2021 eruption are still degassing harmful volcanic gases such as carbon dioxide at a high enough rate that under specific circumstances, their concentrations could injure or worse to people. While 1,000 parts per million of carbon dioxide leads to lower work productivity across the board, 5,000 parts per million marks levels that OSHA considers the maximum average exposure limit over 8 hours. Also, 40,000 parts per million is immediately dangerous to life and human health, and 70,000 or more parts per million can cause death or unconsciousness within minutes. Carbon dioxide is heavier than air, so it pools on the ground in low-lying areas where it can accumulate in very high concentrations. These carbon dioxide gas levels have been heightened at various sites within several kilometers of the eruption that occurred, as, while people might think of the ground as a singular solid mass, it is actually quite porous. Cracks and faults allow gas to travel upwards towards the surface, where they can then pool in basements and low-lying areas of structures. These carbon dioxide emissions have not, I repeat, not increased in the past week, and in fact have remained fairly heightened since around January 3rd of 2022. This is not all that unexpected, as at-death bodies of magma can cause elevated levels of degassing for years or even decades after they are in place, hence why everyone on Japan's volcanic island of Miyakejima was required to wear a gas mask at all times for 5 years following a major eruption in 2000. So, how is a recent report on the Cumbre Vieja volcano being misinterpreted or greatly taken out of context? Simply put, as part of a project known as Alert CO2, additional sensors are being placed and their data newly interpreted to better map out where humans and animals should be forbidden from entering at this time. At several locations, before it was unknown what the level of carbon dioxide was on the ground there, and now we know that it is in fact elevated above normal levels due to recently in place sensors. These levels have not recently increased, they have been there since 2022, just they weren't tested for in those specific spots. Thus, I can truly say that no Canary Island volcanoes, including Cumbre Vieja, are showing any signs that they might erupt soon, or even new signs of unrest, meaning it is safe to travel to the island of La Palma as long as you keep out of the small minority of the island where gas emissions are too high.